Hi, this is Brian with Stratton Creations, and this week I'm going to show you how I made a modern glass top coffee table. Okay, well, I've got some pieces cut out to the right size, at least the width, and now I'm going to lay out the length that I want that the glass is, and so I'm laying it out on the table. It's just a lot easier to just use my work table for layout. I can do my math, I can just do it right here on the table, get my center line, get each end basically referenced off of one end of the table, and it's gonna allow me to get the angles that I'm looking for. So I got my center line and I'm looking for a specific angle, but I don't know what the angle is, so I'm able to get that by drawing it out on the table. I have how wide I want the top of the table to be, and I have how narrow I want the base of the table to be. And so that allows me to lay out and get my angle. And so I set up the angle on the chop saw, I cut each side, and I get it to the right length and just go from there. And so I laid out both legs, both ends, and actually the piece that I'm laying out now will actually be on the floor. So that's the base, and then it's going up. And you'll see at the end, you'll see how it's gonna work out. And so what I'm gonna do is layer two layers of Baltic birch plywood. And I like using Baltic birch plywood for this kind of project because there's no voids in it and there's a lot more plies. There's a lot more layers in the plywood. And so it looks really cool. General plywood that you get at the home center will have a lot fewer plies, and so the plies are thicker, but they don't look as clean and they don't look as good. And so Baltic birch plywood, each layer is Baltic birch, and so when you buy plywood at the home center, the core layers aren't what is on the veneer on the outside. And so that's one reason why I like this Baltic birch plywood. It's a lot heavier, makes it a lot more difficult to cut pieces out, you know, when you have a full sheet of it trying to rip it through the table saw, but it's a much better product in the long run. And so what I did there was I glued up the ends and I just held them together with brad nails. And now I'm laying out for the center part. And I'm gonna do the same thing. I just took a measurement. I made some marks, and I'm measuring twice there, by the way. Measure twice, cut once. That always saves you in the long run. So here I'm just laying it out, making sure it all looks good. And then I will glue in that middle section and then tack it together with brad nails. And that tagging it together with brad nails allows me to go ahead and move along with the process. And so the glue is gonna do the work, but the brad nails holds it together so the glue can dry. And so here I am, and I'm looking at it, and I have the base is a little bit longer or a little bit wider than the two legs. And that's just because of the stock that I had on hand. I'm using a bunch of scrap that I had. And so not really liking the way it looks, so I'm going ahead and cutting it all to be the exact same width. Ripping everything down at the table saw. And there I am just walking around thinking. I do a lot of that. I just kind of stand there and think. And there's my buddy JT. He came over. He needed to borrow my oscillating tool. He's a fellow woodworker in town. We go to church with him, and he's a great dude, and really love that guy. And his oscillating tool broke, and he was in the middle of a project the day before, so he was just coming over on his lunch break. He works at one of the hospitals in town. And here I am, I'm setting up a board on my miter gauge at the table saw, and what I'm gonna do is mill out a couple mill out a couple of half laps, and so the long piece and the short piece will go together. So one will be on the top and the other will be on the bottom, and you'll see here in just a second. And what I'm doing, I didn't want to bother with putting in a dado stack. I just milled it all out pretty easy. And so there you go. There's the shorter side and the longer side and how they go together. And you can see how I'm kind of layering everything together, and this nice snug joint, and that's the way you want it. Nice and snug, not too tight, not too loose. And so I'm just kind of sanding and routering the edges smooth, getting it to be nice and smooth but still have that nice crisp look to it. And you can see what I've done is notched out for the glass to sit in on each end there. I don't know if you can tell. And I'm just putting on a layer of shellac to seal everything. Shellac dries super fast, and I live in Texas and it's hot, and so it dries really fast. So I just put on a good thick coat of shellac, and by the time I'm done putting on the layers, where I started is already dry. So I'm able to go ahead and just start putting on a couple layers of polyurethane. I'm using water-based poly here. It's just Minwax water-based poly, and I had a couple cans of satin, and that's what I use for this particular project. I typically like the glossy look, actually. I like the way it pops the grain, but I just had some satin on hand, so that's what I'm using. And so that's that. Okay, hey, thanks for watching. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, and subscribe. Dang it. Thanks for watching. Oh. What?
Start over.
Hey, thanks for watching. Okay. Hey, thanks for watching. That's ingenious. What is it? It's so stupid. It just what you like me. Oh, man. What's my hair doing? Hey, thanks for watching. We really appreciate it. We here at Stratton Creations, we try to do weekly videos. So please check us out next week. We should have another video out. It might be a vlog, might be a project. I don't know. But we're going to do videos every week. So check us out, and please like or hit the thumbs up, whatever it is that it is today. Hit the thumbs up, and please hit the subscribe button. Really appreciate it. Thanks. Bye.